Access code accepted. Welcome to DIY Dentist. Self-dentistry on a budget.
Right. Actually, I really feel...
Relax. It'll be fine. Don't look at the tools.
It'll be fine. Terry Kelleher says there's a proper dentist opening up on the Isle of Norwich.
Yeah, we can't afford it. Costs 12 batteries to even register.
Please voice select option.
I think it's getting a bit easier.
With anaesthetic or without anaesthetic?
Without
anaesthetic.
You have chosen without anaesthetic.
What? Bloody hell!
Look, now you've upset the chickens. We haven't got any anaesthetic.
The tokens, the internet tokens. I've fucking lost them, haven't I? What is wrong with me? I'm totally incapable.
Sure not. You're an extremely capable young woman. I tell you what, why don't you rip Grandad's tooth out and then don't look at the tools!
No, I'd only mess it up. It would be like the pig all over again.
Listen, you were unlucky. And we'd have had to castrate him eventually.
No,
you'll be fine.
I'll make it complete and utter. Grandad?
Probably safe to let him out. Water's gone right down.
What's the flood left us?
Bits of wood, drowned hedgehog, some old Y-fronts. Not bad.
I think these floods are easing up a bit. We've only had three this week and just the one tornado. Anything else?
Plastic cones, rubber Johnny, bits of old carpet, corpse.
Oh, no. Not again.
We'll have to take it up to the body dump.
They used to collect on Tuesdays, but now you've got to lug it up there yourself.
Yes, OK, Mick, thanks.
And they charge us.
Well, yes,
OK. Do you want to buy some chicken eggs?
No, thanks.
What about your dad?
He's not my dad, he's my father-in-law. What happened to your eye?
Fight over an eel.
Over an eel?
And they charge by the weight now, and he's a big bastard. Look.
That's just...
Big thighs.
Well, yeah.
Big stiff thighs.
Mick, that's no way to talk about...
He won't fit in the wheelbarrow.
Eh?
The wheelbarrow. He won't fit.
Look, we're not putting him in the
wheel... So do you want to buy some chicken eggs?
Are they seagull eggs painted brown?
Not yet.
Why don't skinny people ever end up dead in our garden?
Mick, this is another human being. This is a mother's son. A man with thoughts and hopes and... dreams. No, here he is. His life's journey's over. Washed up against the fence of our garden. Just centimetres from next door's garden.
Traffic news, there's more tailbacks on the Ufton Causeway where a rickshaw has shed its load. And now, something mellow.
What's that?
You've been invited to the birthday party of the area controller.
What? Big deal, yeah? No, that must be a mistake.
Well, you've got to go.
No, even if it is for me, she won't notice if I don't go.
But you can't risk snubbing her. Johnny No Fingers snubbed her once. Well, Johnny Fingers as he was then.
No, I'm not going. Now, the only reason that hoodlums like her flourish is because decent people just don't stand up to her, just because she's got protection rackets and thugs, and so I'd better take a present. And
God, yes.
Right, OK. Mick, I am actually a bit short. You remember when we went to Guildford-on-Sea and I loaned you all those AAAs to pay for the...
I put them all in a dogfight.
You lost the lot.
Yeah, I bet on the dog and the bloke won.
I can't skin this bloody hedgehog! Been beaten by the corpse of Mrs. Sodding Tiddlywinkle!
Oh, God, that's not so bad. Look, we can use that bit as a hairbrush. Hey, come on. I know with Mum gone, it's tough, and it's a daunting world to be 17 in. See, when I was young,
we were lucky with lots of great stuff. We had buses and shops and mains electricity and banks that had money in. Well, we thought that they didn't. What I'm getting at is all this, you know, the looting and then the lynching and stuff. It's just a blip.
A blip.
What I mean is, you know, be confident.
Look, do you want to come inside for a cup of tea?
Are you trying to harvest one of my kidneys?
No.
Because that'll cost you.
For the last time, I'm not interested in any of your organs.
Yeah, if I had a penny for every time I've heard that.
You got a party invite. You've got a party invite.
Yeah. Big Delia invited me to her birthday party. I don't know why.
Well, she's not going to be very happy.
Eh?
When you don't go because you despise her.
Well, possibly.
You called her a barbaric monster.
Did I? Are you sure? Did I say that?
You're totally right.
Am I?
Yeah. You and me were the only ones that don't suck up to her. There.
Thanks.
When are you going to tell Grandad about, you know?
Oh, soon.
Excuse me. Hello?
Yeah, I'm just waiting for the ride. Yeah, soon.
Hello? Hello?
Oh, hello.
There appears to be a body in my garden.
A body? Is there? Well, that's a bit of bad luck. Oh, dear. Yeah, that's a big one.
Any idea how it got there? Because I think I saw a body in your garden earlier.
No, don't think so. Not in our garden.
See, the water blows this way, you see, so how is it possible?
Backwash.
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 Yeah, it's where the water washes back.
Or it could have been dragged there by otters.
Yes, it could have been otters.
Otters can throw bodies over fences, can they?
Well, maybe he...
was alive when he climbed into your property and then he had a fatal heart attack.
In the night?
I would have seen him. I have a 200-watt security light powered by my new wind turbine.
Yeah, we're going to get a security light.
What powered by that? Isn't that one of the windmills that Don Quixote charged at?
Uh-huh. Very good.
Look, mate, that body is just one of those unanswerable mysteries like the Mary Celeste, or who assassinated Tony Blair, or why the Shard fell down, or why the...
Oi, you! Did you see how this got here?
Nah, didn't see a blind zero, bruv.
Tiga? Tiga, my otter like it, then search mar, eh? Otter.
Was that me?
No, that was thunder, Mick.
Hey,
do you want to sleep the night in our shed?
Never sleep in a room with only one door. My mum taught me that, and to never cook a tortoise in a microwave.
You remember your mum, then?
Yeah, she gave me this. Advice and wisdom and stuff.
It's a shopping list.
No, might look like a shopping list to you.
Look, I used to teach adult literacy. I could teach you to read.
To read what? Words?
Yeah, words.
So I could read tattoos?
Tattoos, yeah. And signs and books even.
So I could read tattoos so I'd know who's in what gang and stuff?
Well, yeah.
So what does that say?
That's a number plate. They're not words.
You can't really read, can you? Good try, mister. You ain't tricking me out of a kidney that easily.
And that is the true religious message of Chrislam, that everybody is right and nobody is wrong.
Another scorpion in the outside bog.
Listen, Mick.
That's the last of the Jeffrey Archers. I shall miss wiping my arse on him.
Yes, Mick.
Other side, bad ear.
Mick, your granddaughter has got some very good news, which is that she has a boyfriend.
A proper boyfriend, not like the other one.
I had no way of knowing he was a woman.
No, of course not, darling. Anyway,
this admirer of Keir's.
I haven't met him, but he makes her happy.
Which is great.
Oh, yes, of course. No, absolutely. A terrific princess.
And also, the interesting thing about him is that he's... Well,
He's what?
He's Dutch.
I met him up the dump last week, and since then we've gone scavenging together a couple of times.
Oh, that's nice, isn't it, Grandad?
Dutch. Fucking Dutch.
All right, Mick, let's... This
poxy immigrant scum, they come over here, they take our work, they take our houses, they steal our turnips. Now, don't get me wrong, I don't condone all this cloggy bashing, but let's be honest, they bring it upon themselves. All I am saying is, why are they all bloody well over here? Oh. Why can't they stay in Holland?
Because there is no Holland. There's just the top of a hill near what was once Eindhoven.
Well, what sort of race is stupid enough to have a country below sea level? I mean, it's just asking for it.
I don't believe this.
Oh, our country's not big enough. We must build an extension out there on the sea. We are tall and blonde, everything will be fine. I'm sorry, Duchess. I love you to death, but I can't bear the thought of you with some dyke monkey.
Well, actually, that went a bit better than I expected.
Don't forget to warm the
goat. What the?
Of course, it's Tuesday.
Songs for food! We sing songs for food! A sweet song for sweet potato! A song for
wrong. Thousands of English boys out there, and she has to choose a cloggy.
Oh, actually, the C word's a bit offensive.
Some poxy little tulip muncher.
So's that. Listen, Mick, just go a bit easy, because he likes this boy, and I think he'll be good for confidence, which has been a bit shaky ever since her mum...
Dumped us for that rich git.
Well, I wouldn't put it quite like that.
Well, she dumped us. He's rich, and he's a git.
Look, Grandad.
Says he's English. You better get Delia a present.
Hey?
As an apology. I can't believe you didn't go to that party.
Well,
madness.
He decided not to go.
Yes, on ethical grounds.
Oh, Jesus, not the ethical bollocks.
Well, some of us...
Thought after Bono was eaten by those Ethiopians, I wouldn't have to listen to that shit anymore.
Yes, well, some of us feel
that... Can't hear that. Bad ear.
Some of us feel that morally we have...
Do you think we should run?
Run? No. No, we're not criminals. We're decent, upright citizens. Actually, yeah, let's run.
And those windmill bunnies will give her all sorts of diseases.
Oh.
Cholera.
Look.
Yellow fever. Dutch elm disease.
No, Mick, that's trees. Look.
Here, wanna buy some crocodile skin shoes?
Have you got some?
Not yet. No, naughty.
I mean, what have cloggies ever given us? Porn, Dutch caps and one-eared painters. I'm warning you, you'll stink of herrings.
You will not stink of herrings. You won't stink of herrings. Why don't you say something?
Because he doesn't leave any gaps.
Listen, you have a voice, so use it. You need to stand up and assert yourself. You need to... Oh, bloody hell!
Excuse me.
Excuse me? How come the body's on our side of the fence?
Is there one there too?
Yes, the same body.
No, That's not the old body. I took that up the dump. This is a different body. Look, he's wearing a Mac.
The face is the same.
But look, this one hasn't got a moustache. Maybe he's the twin brother of the other body. He probably died of shock when he discovered his brother had a heart attack. Either that or he was dragged here by an otter.
You put a Mac on him, you shaved off his moustache and you threw him back over the fence. Threw him over the fence. And what's more, That car?
That's Big Delia's car!
Oh, Jesus.
It's been nice knowing you.
I knew this would happen.
It'll be fine. She's probably just passing.
Delia forced Sonny Watson's mum into prostitution.
I'm not sure how much forcing there was. Nick, she was quite prostitute-y already. I'm told.
Look, talking of prostitutes, let's be very careful not to make any reference to Delia's early career.
Right.
Or that of her mother.
And grandmother.
Grandmother?
Yes, and
her... Whoa, stop right there. What we don't know, we can't say. Oh, and nobody mentioned what happened to her husband.
What did happen?
She topped him.
Yeah, well, we don't know that. For all we know, it was a freak accident involving a steamroller and lots of weasels.
Is that thunder?
No, Mick, that was you.
The main thing is to be confident and to...
What are you doing?
Oh, I'm never going to remember all this. I'm just writing murderer, weasels and whore on my hand.
No, don't do that. That's... Area controller, what a nice surprise. Happy birthday for yesterday. Sorry I didn't make it, but I came down with a dose of
syphilis.
Yes, syphilis. Cup of tea?
Thank you. And what's his face? We'll have some.
Oh, good. There's no milk. Kia, would you go fetch the...
What's that say? On a hand?
It says, weasels, murderer and whore.
Weasels, murderer and whore?
Yes. It's,
A law firm?
Yes. It's a law firm that she's thinking of consulting. Kia, milk.
I hope you got the milk from one of my approved outlets and not some roadside cloggy bastards.
Oh, absolutely.
Yes, 100%.
How many cloggies does it take to change a light bulb? 11. One to change the bulb and 10 to crew the submarine.
Here. I've been told that some of them are basically male prozzies targeting our women because they don't see our women as people. And, of course, a lot of their women drowned.
Is that right? I'll tell you what, I'll ask what's his bollocks here because he's Dutch.
Of course, I've also heard that some of these Dutch gentlemen and their English lady friends form loving and...
Leave.
Of course.
And you, what's your name?
His name is Pick van der Linden, and he's my boyfriend.
Yes, actually, sweetheart.
Or at least he was.
Actually, sweetheart.
Until he got stolen by some hoary faced whore.
Sweetheart.
No, I have a voice, and I'm using it.
Yes, it's just now not quite the right.
She is a barbaric monster. You said so yourself.
I didn't. She's not been well.
Syphilis?
No, not syphilis, no.
You leave now.
Oh, and you don't have lovely eyes. They're shit!
Here, please.
Piss off, dice monkey!
Top up?
I know what you're thinking. My poor darling Frank barely cold in his grave. She's after hot Dutch cock.
No, I don't think you're after hot... No, not at all, no. Probably the grief.
Edward, you are perspicacity itself. It is the grief. And the grieving comes in many forms. The binge eating, the binge drinking, the sex with fit young blokes. And I think it's going to take a long time to work through the grieving.
Well, you can't rush grief.
Frank, God rest his soul, would understand. Because through it all, there's a little bit of Frank that's still here with me.
Well, the spirit of loved ones does...
No. There's a little bit of Frank still here with me in my handbag. It's all they could find. After the tragic accident with the weasels.
That must be very comforting.
Now then, Edward. You didn't. Sideways. You didn't come to my party.
Incidentally, what Kia was...
It's great. We stoned a poacher.
Well, that's...
Because of your absence, I was unable to offer you an opportunity.
Opportunity?
In light of your former métier, Edward, I want you to teach me how to read and write.
You can't read and write?
No, obviously, because that's what I just said. I'm not a moron, Edward, because you might have noticed I just said perspicacity and métier.
And they were very well used.
Mm, I'm good with words. I just can't understand the little fuckers on a piece of paper.
Ish, bash, bosh, here we go.
So, my friend, where's it hiding now?
Oh, I thought it was there too.
Now, a real man isn't going to stop there, is he?
And if I were to decline this teaching
opportunity. Would anything bad happen?
Who knows? Game of life can play such cruel tricks.
Well, on reflection, I'd like to accept your offer of this arrangement.
Good boy. Oh, by the way, don't tell anyone about this or I'll kill them. Now, is there anything I can do for you?
No.
Drugs, batteries, enemies eliminated? Some nice homemade fudge.
Really? No.
Surely you must want something.
No.
No?
Oh, no, N-O.
N-O. You see? Lesson one. We started.
Well, this has been lovely. Do drop by any time.
Delia, we've just slaughtered a lamb. We were wondering if you'd like the prime cut of rump.
A bit of dead sheep's ass. Well, thank you. That's a nice wind turbine.
Yes. Yes, it is.
But aesthetically... Aesthetically, I think it would look better on top of Edward's house.
I'll get on to it.
Oh, hang about. Boot! What am I like?
You see, if you turned me down, Edward, he'd have met with a... Well, I don't have to spell it out for you, do I?
No.
Good, because I couldn't. That was a joke about me being illiterate. Oh. Keep up. Good luck with the syphilis.
Here, if you're mates with Big Delia, why can't you get her to fix me up with a dentist?
I am not mates with Big Delia.
All right, sweetie.
Listen, don't judge your Dutch chum too harshly, because, you know, he may have had to hook up with Delia due to circumstances beyond his control. All right, I know you think I'm Delia's bitch because, well, because that's the expression you used, but I can assure you that I am...
What's all this?
Just some tokens of everybody's admiration.
What?
On account of you being Big Delia's bitch.
I am not Big Delia.
Songs for food.
Oh, no.
Songs for food? Sweet song for a sweet potato? A salad?
Okay, okay, you can have those turnips.
What song would you like?
No, no, we don't want any music, thank you.
You got to have a song.
Okay, you choose. No singing.
I wish J&S would stop bothering us.
I think that toast might be done. Listen, sweetheart, I can assure you that I have not entered into an arrangement that is in any way tawdry or shameful. I just can't tell you what it is. And I will be visiting her twice a week. Yeah, what do you do? I don't think that's a very...
Oh, you all right, princess? You look at her. Oh,
well done, Kia. That was very... Very